cuisine, patrada. I mentioned about this dish in many of our videos, and the Konkani's love for this patrada is just intense. So this video is for all those dear friends of mine who wanted patrada recipe. A special mention to Jisha Rani, Sabina and Radhika. Since my all-time favorite is the patrada which my mother makes, I requested her to prepare this video. And apart from the normal patrada, she is also presenting her speciality panna patrada, which means the normal patrada with a beautiful seasoning. So over to her kitchen. Let's first list out the ingredients needed for patrada. So we need obviously the colocasia leaves or chembe ela. Then we need 1 cup toor dal and 1 cup rice. Rice and toor dal in equal proportions. Next is 1 cup or 1.5 cups grated coconut. Then we need 10 to 15 red chilies according to your spicy level, and then some bilimbi, which is called as bimbul in Konkani. This is also called as irumban puli. A small piece of tamarind and a small piece of asafoetida or hing. Finally, salt as per your taste. In case bilumbi is not available, you can just increase the amount of tamarind. Firstly, we need to wash and soak the dal and rice together for half an hour to 45 minutes. While it's getting soaked, we'll just prepare the leaves. One has to be very careful while selecting the colocasia leaves. As much as possible, choose very tender colocasia leaves because they contain less amount of calcium oxalate, which is the main reason for creating an itching sensation in your throat. So select very tender leaves and then devein them, that is remove the veins and the stem part from the middle of the leaves very carefully with a sharp knife. Honestly speaking, I never tried this patrada recipe, and I always had the luxury of eating the patrada which is prepared by my mother-in-law or my mother. So our leaves are ready after washing and deveining. So let's prepare the masala now. For that, take the grated coconut. The more coconut you add, the softer will be your patrada. So here we are adding double the amount of coconut, a small piece of tamarind, red chilies. You can even add chili powder instead of red chilies. So here my mother is adding both chili powder and red chilies. Next comes the bilimbi cut into slices, and then the asafoetida or hing. Salt as per your taste. And finally, the soaked toor dal and rice. Grind these into a smooth batter, and this batter is called patrada pita in Konkani. So now the batter is ready, and we have to apply this batter on the leaves. So keep the biggest leaf upside down on a clean surface or plate, and then apply a layer of ground masala uniformly on the back of the leaf. Normally we use our fingers and cover the entire leaf with a thick layer of masala. This process is called patrada saroche in Konkani. Saroche means smearing or spreading. Once you have covered the first leaf with the ground masala, keep another leaf on top of the first leaf
and repeat the process till you get layers of 8 to 10 leaves. Take care to apply the masala generously so that the layers are not separated. Try to give a uniform thickness to the patrada layers. So once you get a good thick layer of leaves, start folding the layers on both sides and apply masala on them. So start rolling from one end and apply masala on the layers and continue rolling till you reach the other end. Make sure to roll them tightly so that the leaves are stuck together and it won't open up when we make the slices of these rolls. So the patrada rolls are ready and these are called patrada lolo in Konkani. Lolo means roll. So once the rolls are ready, use a sharp knife and cut these rolls into slices of 1 to 2 inches thickness. Now the slices are ready and we are going to cook these in a steamer. So heat water in a steamer and place these slices in the steamer and cook for 15 minutes on high flame and another 5 minutes on low or medium flame. This special steamer is called Pedavan in Konkani. You can place a banana leaf or another colocasia leaf on the steamer so that the slices are not stuck to the steamer. So once it's properly cooked for 10 to 15 minutes, your steaming hot patradas are ready. And you can serve it with lots of coconut oil on top. So along with the normal patrada, my mother also makes panna patrada. Panna means seasoning. So for that, heat a kadai, add oil, and then add some fenugreek seeds or methi seeds into the oil. With the fenugreek seeds, add mustard also. So this dish is called panna patrada because we are adding a very beautiful seasoning to this dish. So for this panna patrada, we need another special ingredient, which is the masala water. So for that, add 2 cups of water to the mixy jar in which we have ground the patrada masala and make 2 cups of masala water. Now once the mustard seeds splutter in the oil and gives a good aroma, add the masala water to the kadai and just give it a boil. Once the masala is hot, place the patrada slices into this masala and let it get cooked with a closed lid. You can taste and add salt or adjust the salt as per your need. Flip the patrada slices occasionally so that all the sides are cooked properly. Bring it to a good boil and see that it's half cooked. Alternatively, you can even do this process of seasoning and adding masala, water and slices in a cooker itself and let it get cooked in the cooker. But here my mother is cooking the patrada slices in the pan and then later she transfers the half cooked patradas into a vessel and transfer it into a cooker to get cooked completely. So you can see that the masala water is somewhat thick now. So now just transferring this into a vessel so that we can keep it in the cooker. So when it's completely transferred into the vessel, just place the vessel in a cooker and let it get cooked completely for another 10 to 15 minutes. So once it's completely cooked, your tasty panna patrado is also ready. Serve these steaming hot soft patrades with lots of coconut oil on top and this will be a perfect side dish for your lunch. So this video is presented by my mother Mrs. Vidyaji Shenoy and videography is by my father Mr. R. Gopalakrishna Shenoy.